How do you want me to handle this, Steve? He asked Nobles. Well, Dan, why don't you take charge of it, and I'll assign Lenny to work with you on it. Davidson nodded, and without changing expression, went outside and set to work. Later, he admitted to a certain excitement that day. I'd be lying if I said I didn't get charged up on a homicide. Yeah, it was a challenge to me. Any homicide investigator who sees a body laying there and no perpetrator in sight, it's a challenge. A lot of homicides I went to, a man standing there with a gun saying, I did it and I'm glad. But you get a body that's been there a couple of days, that's a challenge, a real one. You've also got an uneasy feeling. What if you don't solve it? What if you don't solve it? That's there every day, every minute. That uneasy feeling gets worse, too, as the case drags on. 6. Daniel Davidson, Jr. was introduced to homicide at age 15 by his father, the sheriff of Clay County in the Appalachian Mountains of eastern Kentucky. His father took him to a cabin where an old man, an old woman, and their two grown but feeble-minded children had been slaughtered over a boundary dispute at their crude supper table while eating cornbread and soup beans, the Kentucky mountain term for pinto beans. Davidson would never forget the sight of the old man's brains mingled on the plate with his soup beans, but it wouldn't affect his taste for the beans, one of his favorite foods. In the 30 years that had passed since, Davidson had been witness to the effects of more murders than he could remember, so many that he needed something to remind him of individual cases. Under his living room coffee table, he kept a grisly scrapbook, fat with photographs of victims of murders he had investigated. In it were people who had been shot, stabbed, garroted, hung, scalded, clubbed, hacked, choked, smothered, left out to freeze, run down by vehicles, and otherwise dispatched.